caught it with him and then poked it back. And now,
we got props.
Is that a Superman cape? I believe it is.
Look at Horsey. He's got the Clark Kent glasses. No.
Brian Elliott down in his net is gone for a little skating. This went around behind. Let's see what he's going to do here. He is Clark Kent and Superman all at once. That's not fair.
He
goes left-handed, and then he scores from the ice.
Oh, you think these guys don't have creativity? I don't know if that was Clark Kent-ish or Superman-ish, but Pierre.
How many pieces of the puck went in the net? It was a trick puck.
He's got the puck. Look at how strong he comes, and the puck just disintegrates.
He had a great first attempt, and now he's asked for the lights to be turned down here.
And
we
now
got Chewbacca
this. Chewbacca
in the building.
And now this. Bang!
Chewie buries it.
He let that rip too.
But I had to get any points. Score! Off the post, and here comes the hat.
Watch a point. Can you believe he called the shot? Look at him. One-on-one snapper.
Let's see if he conserves some energy here, Jim.
Holy smokes. 108-8.
Look at the players. Crowd reacts, but so do his.
But he gets two more shots because there's a final in this event.
I think the other guys just say, go ahead, it's yours.
Yeah, just take the championship, take the points.
That's unbelievable.
And they all wear pads and they play in the NHL.
The goal.
And they're going, uh-oh.
All right, down to the final two. Paul Stastny of the Colorado Avalanche and Phil Kessel of the Toronto Maple Leafs. Eric Saul, go ahead.
Well, since it's not a hockey market in Toronto, we're going to take Paul Stastny of the Colorado Avalanche.
Well, he works in a shot at the Toronto Maple Leafs and then takes Paul Stastny of the Colorado Avalanche. All right, and so we're not going to make Phil Kessel wait any longer. Go ahead, Nick Lidstrom, and make the announcement for Phil Kessel. Go ahead, Nick, announce it.
All right. All right, we're happy with our last pick in the draft. We'll take Phil Kessel.
You know what? There is no shame. There are more than 600 players in the National Hockey League. There were only 36 drafted today. There are several hundred out there that would love to be here today. So Phil Kessel. Phil, come on down for a second. Phil, come on down for a second. Phil? Hey, Phil. Phil, come on down for a second. Come on down. Come on down. Let's give a hand for Phil Kessel, guys, who waited an awful long time.
Now Tomas Hertl pulls out a Justin Bieber mask. Remember, Binnington recently challenged Justin Bieber on social media. Binnington said, 10 breakaways. If you score, I'll dye my hair platinum blonde. So here's Hertl slash Bieber, Binnington the same.
That is awesome. Way to go, Tomas Hertl.
And Bieber responded, if I score a goal on Bennington, $10,000 to charity.
Here we go.
And we are told
we're back into it.
The challenge will take place in the very near future. Justin Bieber on Jordan Bennington.
You know, looks like he's going to go to his right, but this should be really exciting. I had the pleasure of playing with Mike Gardner for a few years in Washington, and what a great guy, and talk about an ambassador to the game.
And here we go.
slip there, maybe hurt.
He did
Got
it!
Him.
He did it! Outstanding, this young kid. What a season he is having.
What a lap. And hey, don't forget, he had a slip as well. When he hit that corner, on the third corner, he had a slight little slip. And the guys on the bench are having a wonderful time with him as he goes by.
PK Subban coming on. And he's, I think he's doing his best Jágr impersonation. Leave it to PK to get creative again. Look at Jágr, that is fantastic.
This is great.
Paying a little homage to one of the best players in the history of the National Hockey League, PK Subban, being Jaromír Jágr.
Here comes Jágr / Subban. And he hits the post and then backhands it in.
Gotta get the salute.
Yep.
Gotta get the salute. Yeah, you know, Jágr, JJ's gonna come out and make sure he says thanks for the paying homage to me. How about Jágr Jágr being here?
Incredible.
44 years old later this month. Just an amazing, amazing hockey player, amazing personality.
Coyote Mike Smith. Is that not unbelievable how much that curled?
Wow.
But if you were going to handicap this event and pick a guy that could do that, it might have been him.
Metropolitan Division.
You're up.
I've always wanted to do this. We have a trade to announce. It's worked out for both teams in the past, so we're going to go with history here, and we're going to trade Tyler Seguin for Phil Kessel.
A little bit of history repeating here.
I hope that's okay.
Do you see the sense of humor here?
And 15 first-round draft picks.
All right, well, you got to get up. You got to get over there.
I'm sorry, Phil.
Say your goodbyes. Tyler, did you see this coming at all?
You never expected to get traded. Yeah, it's tough to swallow right now, but I'm really excited. A big opportunity over there with White, so it'll be fun.
It's deja vu all over again for you two.
Well, the referees on the ice will make sure everything is done properly. And Kessel and Seguin are ready to go in the first heat of the fastest skater competition.
Start is imperative here, getting off that first start, not jumping the gun, but coming around this first turn, you got to make sure that you don't get too wide. You try to stay tight. Now they're going to explode, and this is where Phil Kessel really, really has an advantage because of his low center of gravity, and he gets around, and it's a tight one coming in.
Oh, that is tight, man. I think Kessel may have just gotten him. We got a pretty good vantage point here right on the finish line.
Phil Kessel has such great edge work coming around, especially on his left side.
Well, he took the jersey off the first time. He keeps the Blue Jacket jersey on this time. Comes to a complete stop.
Yeah.
And now Voracek.
Getting a lot of guys going back for more ammo here tonight.
Tic-tac-toe, baby.
suck it, Phaneuf.
Catherine, well, you're close. Are you angry if you don't go number one?
I want to be last. I need a car, so.
Do you remember what you did the last time we had an all-star game and there was a draft? Do you have your camera ready?
Yeah. Phil Kessel sitting at my table, so we're all set.
Are you having fun this weekend so far?
Kind of.
I don't know, Pierre. What's going on back there?
Well, thank you, Catherine. Where are all your friends?
I don't know. I'm by myself here, so I'm pretty happy.
I don't think you are. I saw you on your phone. Who were you texting?
I just put on Instagram some pictures, me and you.
Okay, you've had a chance to evaluate both teams. Who do you want to pick you?
I want to be last. I need a car so bad, like, that I need it.
I think you might get it.
Thanks God.
Darren, Catherine, back to you.
Geez, I wonder who that was behind that piece of paper. Alexander Ovechkin remains available. Final picks are coming up, and look who's still there. Happy as can be. Ordering his keys, Alexander Ovechkin.
Darren, you've been through this before, Mark. You were never drafted coming out of junior. You're playing in the
state. I'm still here.
Ovi's still here. How are you handling this?
But I need a car.
I have a great chance to still get drafted ahead of Alex Ovechkin, so I feel great right now.
I think I'm so bad.
So bad.
Sell yourself to Foligno or Taves. What would you bring to their team?
I don't know.
Foligno, I'm here.
A lot, I guess.
Jonathan, they're there for you. He's here for you. Both of them are here for you.
Come on, guys.
Three players left. Hi, Ovi. We see you. Lobbying for the car.
This is the difference between a potential car and obviously...
I think they're too nice to him. He asked for a free car, and he may get it. So. And Team Foligno, you're on the clock.
Yeah, just piss him off. Who cares? What's he gonna do?
I will take Alex Ovechkin.
The captain of the Washington Capitals, Alex Ovechkin, leads the NHL this season in power play goals. He has won the Rocket Richard Trophy four times during his nine full NHL seasons.
Refusing to come out.
Maybe he's requesting a trade.
Two players left. Alexander Ovechkin, that close to new wheels.
Just buy the car, Ovi.
Thomas is coming out in the goalie pads. What about Cam Ward? Is he going to come with the mask on? And Cam Ward for Carolina. You want to guess what the times will be? 16, 17.
Isn't that like when a semi's backing up, Doc? What's that sound? Do they make that when the goalies are going here?
There they go. Thomas wiped out, back to his feet. Cam Ward is very careful. This is actually closer than you'd think at the end. Well, good sports all.
I hear you.
He's at the red line charging ahead. 8.2. And the last for Alexander Ovechkin. Oh!
It's the goal again, right, Doc?
Yep. Go get the illegal one, if he has one. Nobody's going to call for a measurement unless Lindstrom knows more about the rules than... the rest of us.
Oh, and now OV will.
Okay.
Nice. We're using Chris Letang's stick.
Manny Bylsma, Bruce Boudreau, really enjoying this.
That didn't register. He gets to go again. He's getting good and warmed up now.
Never works for me, but that's in the car.
Bobby should go get either Weber or Chara's stick. With the Letang stick. It didn't register.
I believe they're to be calibrated once a month, aren't they? I've heard that one too.
It's the 29th of January, 2011. Mark it down. 97.2. We do get the showdown between the two blasters.
I think Patrick Kane, Clark Kent, Super Kane, is the man to beat right now. But Corey Perry and Logan Couture still have one more chance each.
Oh yeah, a little ghost. Oh, beauty.
That's good stuff.
Yeah, that was really good stuff.
Oh, that's good stuff.
Man, John Scott,
6'8" is all. Daryl Sutter, coach of this team, said that everybody wanted to have at least one shift with John Scott.
Burns is looking for him off of Rene into the back of the net, and the reaction from the captain.
Drag, lost his balance, can't score. Oh my! It's Scott and Kane.
Well, Scott chirped him before, and then Kane went right after him after he got steamrolled in the neutral. That's awesome. Listen to the crowd.
Burns and tucked a nice pass on to Scott. Scott pursued. Score! He's got two.
Putting a little bit of pressure on John Scott, moves it away and goes top cheese on Devin Dubnyk. And watch the reaction from Brent Burns.
Well, your team won $1 million. How are you planning on spreading it around? It's going to go 100 parts of me, and then they're going to just take the rest. Hey, whoa, whoa.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time to award the 2016 Honda NHL All-Star MVP Award as decided by you. The 2016 Honda NHL All-Star MVP scored 2 goals in the tournament and wins as a write-in candidate, John Scott! John Scott is the recipient of the brand new 2016 Honda Pilot Flooring.
There's 7 guys out here. This is Ryan Johansson's attempt, by the way.
Subban's. He's got Jeff Skinner's jersey on. Trying to get a little hometown cook in here.
They're standing for him. Why not? He's got the right colors on. You see Jeff Skinner just waiting to get his jersey back. Let's see how it works. Well, he got iron with the shot. Could not convert. It's for style. It does not necessarily mean you have to score, but he gets another.
Even.
Whoa, through the legs.
Nice.
little Wayne Gretzky batting that puck up and actually trying to go between the wickets and skating backwards.
Oh, he's going to take a pass. Nice pass came from Jamie McBain.
Goes wide.
Oh, he tried it again. Didn't work. An E for effort and a C for Carolina.
Kurosenko to start the third and final round of shots here with the breakaway challenge. Presented by Honda. And he hits the target in the glove of Brian Elliott.
Most creative so far as a duo for all three shots. I think the target coming out a little early tonight, but Tarasenko hits it dead on.
Here we go. You do get three strikes. Corey Crawford skated right to the corner and said, I want no part of this because if he hits it, he has no idea where it's going. I have no idea where it's going.
I just hope I could be lucky again. You know, last year was, it would be tough to top, I think.
Sakic will start to board.
Yes. Yes.
Two.
Yes.
Three.
Yeah!
Oh, he got him. He's got one left.
Oh, yeah.
And he gets it.
He hit that one, Gary. I saw it move.
He's arguing.
You're darn right he hit it.
He is arguing that he hit it with the first shot.
It's four for four.
Hey, we've already been through this, man. You know?
Like the good old days.
No, right? All right, we've already been through this.
Come on,
we talked about this. Right. I thought we figured this out. Yeah, no, seriously, I got this. Seriously.
One shot.
Who you got? Whatever.
No, no, kids, I can do it.
Yeah, no, I got it. I can stop a kid.
Let me have it.
I can stop kids.
No. Come on.
No, come on.
Great things about this is the ability to bring your family and your kids down here. Man,
look at this!
Well, Jagger has been the life of the party here in Nashville, and look at him and his proud dad. As good on Roberto and Corey to have some fun with him, and that's something that he will remember.
Remembers it. I said, "How did it go?" He said, "Yeah, the puck kind of hit the cement, rolled around and ended up behind me, so not very good."
Here's Vancouver's Brock Besser. And he's moved into the lead.
And now an opportunity to rub shoulders with the best player in the game.
And Glenn, don't you think that's a bit of that pay it forward, you know? Come on over, introduce yourself. You play out in the West. We don't see each other very often. You're brand new, but pretty darn impressive.
Well, I said before the game he was nervous. There you go.
Vladimir Tarasenko, one of the most creative scorers in the National Hockey League. Let's see, he's going to fake the slap shot. Well, Elliott was taking a selfie.
That's fantastic. Between two teammates, a good one to take home back to St. Louis. That was pretty creative. I love that.
One shooter to go, an ally of Brady's shot over 101. 101.4 in Washington. Can he do it again here to win? Yes, 105.2, 105 miles an hour. And he gets another shot. 102.7, he would have won with either of them. And the Wales Conference has a 10-point lead in the team competition. Ally of Brady, for the second time, has won the hardest shot competition.
By Carey Price. I don't know where Lundqvist was on that. I guess at the bench. Thrown on across for the return. Score! It is Carlson. Oh, a review on an offside.
After reviewing the play, call on the ice, it was determined that the play was offside, no goal.
Yes. Nope, brought back. back ahead by Barkov. Florida Panther. Enough defense by Letang, and now a goal! Pass ahead to Stamkos, and up to Kucherov! Scores! Three goals on three shots! And the hat trick for him!
Now, I gotta see this again. Bush, did he do this on purpose?
He absolutely did it on purpose. There's no doubt about it.
We're talking about creativity here. Great pass from Stamkos. That's fun. That's fun. When you're that good and you can do this, you're having fun.
He's coming in at a 2-on-1. Heatley looking, draws a shot, score!
Oh, baby!
Heatley. That's an all-star goal!
22 years old, you're not supposed to pull moves like that at 22.
All right, here we go. Neil's second breakaway of the night. Hold on.
Here we go.
There we go.
And that is that who I think it is? I think that's Dierks Bentley. That is Dierks Bentley. Love it. Yes, sir.
He's
Dierks Bentley. What was I thinking?
Who was that guy? I didn't get a scouting report on him.
He is a major, major star here in Nashville. And he's one of these celebrity coaches for the All-Star game. And good on him. He's not a bad skater. So now he has handed Pecorine some of his equipment. Let's see how this works out.
Sticks used to be made of wood, so this is his wood. It'll work. His net's off.
His net's off, coming in wearing a cowboy hat probably for the first time in his life. No, sir, and I think he was shooting the wrong hand.
Wrong hand, yeah. He was going in as a right-hand shot, and of course you remember Ovechkin had the hat and the boa on there.
That was pretty nice.
Quinn Hughes in alone. Beauty.
That was pretty nice.
What composure there. He just put the puck to an area where he couldn't get his stick lifted.
That young lad's a defenseman?
Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
Go in even here.
From the Hartford Whalers, representing all of hockey with great distinction for five decades, number 9.